Mr. Siopa M. Metagar. I am working as assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to give the lecture on DNS in the internet. Now let us see the learning outcomes of this lecture. At the end of this session, the students will be able to explain the concept of DNS in the internet. Second one is, students will be able to explain the concept of resolution. These are the two topics I am going to cover in this lecture, that are DNS in the internet, resolution. Why we have to use DNS in the internet? Okay, DNS is, in the previous lecture we have already discussed about the DNS, domain name system concept, why we have to use in the internet. Okay, if the user has stored a huge amount of data in a single system, to search the data based on the client request, the user may face the problem. For that, we have to use DNS concept in the internet also. Based on that only, they have given three types of DNS in the internet, that are generic domain, country domain, inverse domain. This one is a generic domain, country domain, inverse domain. Now let us see one by one in detail. First one is generic domain. Generic domain defines all the registered host acts according to the generic behavior. It means there are so many domains are there here, that is eurobeach.com, co.edu, gov, info, these are different domains are there. In this domain, I have taken only one example, that is .edu. This is a main domain, that is edu. These are the subdomains. These subdomains have registered to this main domain. These subdomains have to act according to the generic behavior of this domain, that is .edu, that is .educational, that is challenger, and then atc.fsda.edu. These are subdomains have registered to this main domain. These have to act according to this domain. That is, what are the different full form of these different domains? Euro, that is airlines and aerospace companies. Like this, these are the different domains how to use for different purposes. Okay, second one is country domain. It uses two characters country abbreviations, for example US for United States. Second one is, second label can be organizational or they can be more specific national designations. Okay, the United States for example use state abbreviations as a subdivision of US, for example CA.US. For here I have taken, this is a good example for DNS in the internet, ANGA.CUP.CA.US. It means the ANZA, that is the ANZA college is there in Cupertino, Cupertino is there in California, California is there in US, can be translated. It means the ANZA college in Cupertino, Cupertino is in California, California is there in United States. Okay, this is country domain. Here we have to use two characters for defining the country domain. Okay, these are different subdomains are there. Here I have taken only one example, that is ANZA.CUP.CA.US. Okay, next one is inverse domain. It is used to map an address to a name. For example, when a server have received a client request from the client to do a task, okay, the server asks its resolver to send a query to the DNS server to map an address to a name to determine if the client is on the authorized list. If the client is there in authorized list, then only the client can assign some IP address to the client request. If it is not there in the authorized client list, the server can reject it and then it can re-forward to the client only. Okay, these are the this is a good example I have taken here. 121.45.34.132.in_address, then ARPA. This is a one IP address. This IP address, the client can send this IP address to the server. The server can checks this IP address is authorized IP address or not. If it is authorized, then only it can accept. if it is not authorized, then it can rejects. Okay, then it can assign some IP address to ARPA is the one of the historical places. Okay, then inverse domain, as the name itself indicates, first the user can send the IP address, then based on that only he can get the historical places. Okay, next one is resolution. This resolution means mapping a name to address or an addresses to a name is called name address resolution. In this resolution, there are so many subtopics are there, that are first one is resolver, second one is mapping names to address, third one is mapping addresses to name, fourth one is recursive resolution, iterative resolution, last one is caching. Now let us see one by one in detail. Okay, first one is resolver. DNS is designed as a client server application, a host that need to map an address to a name or name to an address. Address calls a DNS client called a resolver. Okay, the resolver accesses the closest DNS server with a mapping request. If the server has the information, it satisfies the resolver. It either refers the resolver to other servers or asks to other servers to provide the information. For example, after getting the client request, the server can check the IP address is available in the server or not. If it is available in the server, then it can send the reply to the client. If it is not available, it won't reject. It can refer to the some other users to send the information required to the client. That is resolver. Next one is mapping names to an address. Okay, most of the time the resolver can give a domain name to the server and ask for the corresponding addresses in the mapping names to an addresses. In the reverse form, mapping address to names, a client can send a IP address to a resolver to be mapped to a domain name. To answer queries of this kind, DNS uses the inverse domain. The good example for mapping address to a name is in inverse domain. In this, the user can send the IP address and then he can request the information required to the client. Okay, based on that only the user can get satisfied. Okay, next one is think and write. This can contains one question: list the difference between mapping names to addresses and mapping addresses to name. Okay, pause the video now and answer the question. Now let us see the answer for this question. Mapping names to address. In this case, the server checks the generic domain or the country domains to find the mapping. First, the user can send the names. Based on that name only, the client have to assign some IP address to the client request, that is addresses. Okay, if the domain name is from the generic domain session, the resolver can receive a domain name such as CHL, that is challenger.atc.fsda.edu. Okay, if it is country domain, that he can gets the Anza College is there in California. California is in Cupertino. Cupertino is in US. That example he can get. Okay, second one, mapping address to a name. However, in the request, the IP address is resolved and two labels in address and ARPA are appended to create a domain accepted by the inverse domain session. For example, if the resolver receives an IP address 132.34.45.121, the resolver first inverts the addresses and then adds the two label before sending. I mean, that two labels are the addresses to the this IP address. Next one is recursive resolution. Recursive means the user can get the answer itself. It means the client or resolver can ask for a recursive answer from the name server. This means that the resolver accept the servers to supply the final answer. It means this is a block diagram for recursive resolution. Here client is there, here the server. Here first the client can send the request to server. If the data is available in this server, then he can reply. If it is not available, then again it can forward it to the next user. Again this next user can search the required data from the client. If it is available, then he can reply. Otherwise, it can send the same request to the next server. The same procedure they will follow until to get the data to the client request. Okay, after getting, he can send the reply through the same path. Okay, here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, these are the requests, and then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are the responses. Whatever the data is required to this client, this data is available in this system. Okay, until to get the answer, the query will be forwarded to the next one. That is recursive resolution. The process can cause itself until to get the required answer. Okay, next one is iterative resolution. In the iterative resolution, if the client does not ask for the recursive answer, the mapping can be done iteratively. If the server is authoritative for the name, it sends the answer. For example, here client is there, there are so many servers are there. Here one-to-one communication will be happened until to get the required answer. Here client, server can send the request and get the reply. Data is not available in this one, again he can get the reply. The same procedure they have to follow to the next users also. EDU, then root server, and this one. Here the data is available, at the end here they can get the data. Same procedure we have to use in a recursive resolution. Here one-to-one communication is there. There the user can forward the same query until to get the data. Okay, these are the references I have used for preparing the above PPT. Thank you.